Hey, horse people.
Gonna be a nice guy. I was just gonna hose off Mr. T and let him dry out here and have a relaxing day. And he told me that he wanted to run and not pay attention to his dad. So, when he told me that, I knew he needed to be ridden a little bit. So, I'm gonna ride him very mildly. Just to, and I'm not doing it to punish him. I'm not doing it to show him who's boss. It's just, he's been getting more and more kind of, I don't want you handling me. I don't want you telling me what to do. I don't want you catching me, I can run. So, because of all that, he needs to get ridden a little bit. Now, I know I'm riding in Crocs and shorts, and I don't recommend this, but I'm not going far. I probably should have boots. You don't want to ride without something with heels so your foot doesn't go through. With these Crocs, my foot comes out of it pretty easy, so if they go through, hopefully I can get my foot out. Again, I'm not going on a long ride. Buddy's getting nervous because he wants to get out and run. He thinks I'm taking him out by myself. This video will show him. I'll go out of his sight just for a couple times. But basically, I'm just going to ride Mr. T a little bit. Let me sit on his back a little bit. And again, he's kind of giving me these kind of directions that I don't want you touching my ears. He pulled away earlier. And he did some other things that he just was kind of telling me that, dude, you haven't really ridden me. You've kind of fed me, and I let you catch me, and I let you let me out, but I'm not going to let you catch me easy. So he kind of ran a little bit, and I had to do the drive line, cut him off, and do all that stuff, but stand. Oh, see, he's backing up now? He knows he's not supposed to back up when I'm trying to get on him. Why is he backing up? Again, those are clues. Remember I talked about that check ride, that pre-flight inspection? This is a clue telling me that he's kind of like, dude, I don't want you getting on me. You haven't ridden me in a while. Well, stand. So this wasn't too bad. Normally he would be running off and taking off. And he stood pretty good. And as I said that, normally he would be a little bit more aggressive. I'm kind of surprised he's not more active. I'm going to have him face you guys a little bit here. See if he'll just stand and relax. Again, I'm talking to the camera. When I talk to the camera, Mr. T always knows I'm not talking to him. Buddy's calling for him because he wants to come out and run with him and play. So that's distracting him. I was going to take him out for both just a little short ride to get some ride time in him because I haven't really saddled him up. I haven't done a whole bunch with him. All the rain and mud, I didn't want to divot up everything. It's just been so damn muddy and everything. And painting my house and doing all this is just kind of, I haven't had a chance to get on these guys much. So it's good that he kind of did that because I probably wouldn't have ridden him. I was just going to come out here, tie him up, hose him off, work on their feet a little bit, and not ride him, because the heat index out here is 106. So, Buddy's going to get his little exercise, because he's having a fit. I could ride him out in the pasture, but I really want to keep this a very low-key. Mr. T's going to be jacked up. He's going to want to go fast. He's going to want to say, okay, let's go to ride, because he's like, quicker I get out of here, the quicker I get back, let's go do this. So I'm gonna really kind of just try to center myself, slow down, and move him around slowly. It's not going to be pretty. It's not going to be good. Some dummy out there going to video, taking the worst clips where I ride and I show a fresh horse and trying to say, oh, this guy can't ride. Look at it. But you notice the people that are saying that, they don't have videos of them riding. They don't have instructional videos out there so people can crack on them. They just want to get out there and be a little drama barn witches online and cause problems. Hey. And you notice these reins look tight, and they look like they're really tight on him. They're not. I'm not putting a whole bunch of pressure on him. As you can tell, I'm only using two fingers. I can get him to turn with two fingers. I'm not putting a whole bunch of pressure. I can get him to back up. I can get him to turn to the left a little bit here. Okay? Although it looks like I'm putting a lot of pressure. Now, if he really starts pulling, I will go ahead and crank up. But just then, I kind of moved his feet a little bit. I kind of showed him softly. He's kind of like, all right, I got it. Kind of dropped his head. This isn't too bad. He wants to go. But he's over here now. He was over here. He's behind us. So I'm going to move Mr. T around a little bit. Now, I did not ask him to do anything but control his head. So everything you saw him do was his decision. Could I have prevented it? Sure. Now he slowed down a little bit and walked calmly. Again, I'm not really trying to control his direction. I'm just trying to, I'm giving his head a little bit. I'm saying, hey, just follow the direction, whatever. I want you to go left or right, go that way. You can pick the seat. Oh, Mr. T. We're just taking a lonely walk. Just want to walk nicely. Walk slowly. Calmly. Lower the head. Nice and calm. Again, I could easily be in a fight with this horse right now. I could be, I'm going to show you how dare you walk off. How dare you go faster. How dare you move when I don't tell you to move. You stupid, stubborn, disrespectful horse. That's all they teach in the horse world nowadays. It just kills me that nobody just said, hey, he's a horse. Work with him. Relax. If you want to fight with him, he'll fight with you. Mr. T will give you a fight you won't forget. But it's just easier on me, easier on him, and he learns a better lesson. I don't have to fight when somebody's on my back. I could get a bit on him and go, man, I'll show you. Let me get a big French snapple twist, gag, double snapple wire bar bit on you, and I'll show you who's boss. It really shows a lack of horsemanship. No reason you shouldn't be riding with a halter. Zero. None. I'll move him around a little bit. I'm going to let him figure out he doesn't have to go fast. If he does, he just gets to go fast for his own reason. Not going to kill me. And he lowers his head. Now, what made this horse walk over here slowly? Because I am a master at domination. I showed him who's boss. By gosh, this horse ain't gonna push me around or run when I showed him, didn't I? Come on, people. Think a little bit. Try to do something other than what other people tell you. Use your damn head for more than a hat or helmet holder. Mr. T, you're being a good old boy. That was a nice, calm walk back, loose reins. I didn't do anything. He kind of went. I'm going to bring him back again, and we're going to walk over here again. When he goes to Buddy, you'll notice his energy picks up. Not the end of the world. Drops his head. Look, if you're out there fighting with your horse, and people out here making videos about me can't ride and I got no seat, and they got no life, there's plenty of bad people out there doing bad stuff. I'm out here trying to help people understand a horse, give horses a better life, and I don't really care what other people do. You have a choice to come to my channel and watch, or you have a choice to leave. But the type of people in the world on the internet today with no accountability want to come to people's channel and do nothing but cause drama, make negative videos. out there, they're not trying to help anybody. They're not trying to do anything good. They're bringing evil into the world. I just don't like it. I mean, look, I point out things that I see that people do, so hopefully you can learn from it. You know, if there was somebody out there who wanted to give constructive, I'm not trying to improve my riding. I'm okay with how I ride. I'm okay with my horses. And there's a lot of people that think my horses are disrespectful, rude, don't listen, unsafe, shouldn't let them eat, I need to put a bit in their mouth. You know, I get all kind of advice on what I need to do better. You know what? I get it, and I don't go to their channel. They come to mine to give me advice. So, it's just irritating. Like I said, could I have controlled Mr. T better when I first got on him? Sure. Could I have made it a fight? Sure. Could I take him out for 10 miles and run the crap out of him and sweat him? Sure. But all I wanted to do is let him know, hey, when I get on you, I'm going to ride you a little bit. I want you to listen. I want you to pay attention. I don't want you to think you're a wild Mustang because I haven't ridden you in a while. And you can run around for me, and when I call you, you get to run, and there's, you know, no big deal. So I'm going to walk him back this way now. Stupid. You know horses are stupid. They don't know how to stop unless you tell them. They don't know what to do unless you're constantly in their face causing pain, spurring them, kicking them. I haven't kicked him or given him any leg commands whatsoever. If you watch my legs ain't moving, they ain't squeezing, they ain't telling them to go forward. Now he's reading my body and I'm thinking, and you may feel me sitting up and you may feel this rein move forward, but my legs have not squeezed, kicked, or done anything to him. So you can watch my legs this time. Saddle you up, and you're just being a mean old horsey. You're a pretty good old boy. I know you are. Alright, so that's my ride. I'm gonna get some dummy you're telling me about that wasn't nothing, and you didn't teach the horse, and he's not even sweating, and he didn't learn it. You know what? The horse told me he learned. The horse told me he knew what was up. He did what I wanted. I didn't have to fight with him. Good old Mr. T, that wasn't so bad, was it, buddy? That wasn't so bad, you old stubborn, mule-headed, big, powerful, Mustang wannabe. Poor Mr. T. Dad made him ride, and he's a big meanie. I know, he's a big old meanie. He's a big old meanie. Some of these damn crybabies want to make a video telling me I don't know how to ride. My horses are out of control. Mr. T, you're a good old boy. Buddy, you big baby, I'll ride you. All right, well, not there. You boys are good boys.